Good morning. Good morning, everybody, and afternoon and evening. Hello and happy Tuesday. So, today we are on day six, and we are going to see who is sticking with it and who has kind of fallen off of the 30-day challenge. So we're almost a week in, which is really exciting for me. So have you filled out your calendar? I would love for you to comment yes, no, I'm sticking with it, or I'm not. Hey Laura, let me know if you've written in your journal today or for yesterday. Hey Krista, how's your calendar coming? Is it getting filled out? Is it feeling encouraging? Are you seeing the boxes and going, ooh, this is fun, this is neat? Or is it just kind of, yes, good, Laura, thanks. Does it feel like another thing to think about? We'll post mine when we get to a week. Yay! Okay, awesome. What insights are you guys getting from this calendar? Are you getting more from it than you thought? Like, I'm sure when a lot of people just saw the blank squares and they're going, I don't see how this could really be helpful. And yet, right when you start filling it out and seeing, you can see how, I mean, just in one day, how up and down your energy or your frustration level gets. But then when you're looking at an entire week, like what we're going to be at tomorrow, you can get a really clear picture of like, okay, wow, this week I didn't sleep well and my energy was off and I got really frustrated. Or you could say, wow, my energy was high all week. I really need to focus that after the new moon, my energy's really high. Or maybe for the new moon, your energy's really low. So, welcome. If you just joined in live, hey, Gail. Gail, are you joining in? Are you filling out your calendar? Yes, no, maybe. I'd love to know. Good morning. If you've gotten any insights, if you're not writing it down, are you guys getting insights just of being a little bit more aware? I always for any program that I do, I have at least a week of observation because it's very telling. Sorry, I'm all itchy. It's very telling as to where we are when we just take the time to observe without judgment. We're able to see really objectively from an outsider's perspective of why certain things aren't working in our lives. So this is my stick with it, please stick with it. We're almost at a week and you can do it. You can take, even if you need to kind of go back through the week and maybe think about yesterday. How did you feel yesterday? And just kind of tap in, maybe do a little visualizing of what happened yesterday. How did I feel? And start with yesterday. If that's where you're at, awesome. Start wherever you are. If you're just, I know a lot of ladies are just joining us right now today. Make sure to grab your PDF calendar in the files section. So they've moved it to the left-hand side of the Facebook group. If you're in the Facebook group on the left-hand side, go to files and you can see the monthly rhythm tracking sheet file. Download that, print it out, join with us, and start today. Think about where you were at yesterday, what went well, what didn't, what your energy level was. You can watch the welcome video and get all the details there. If you started with us on day one and haven't been keeping up, join in today. Let's stick with it. Let's not beat ourselves up and go, oh, I failed. Again, I can't do anything consistently. No, this isn't what this challenge is about. This challenge is about connecting within us and pulling out what we truly desire. So let's stick with it. What do we truly desire? As we're starting to look at what is, So what is it? What is it that you desire? Type in the little type. I love seeing comments, so type away. Have you kind of figured out what it is more that you desire? Have you figured out what's really been keeping you stuck? I have to give complete credit to this little calendar, getting back into my nighttime routine. If you guys know, this has been a struggle for like 3 weeks now of being out of our nighttime rhythm, and it pains me to be out of my nighttime rhythm because I love the stories that I get to tell and the meditation that I guide my kids through. I love that like snuggling being time with them. And not having that, or having it and it being really chaotic and them jumping literally from bed to bed. We have a king bed downstairs and a queen bed downstairs, and they're jumping from bed to bed and hanging on things, and oh my gosh, I didn't have energy for it. So last night, or because of this, I saw that I was the one who had gotten us out of the rhythm. It was all my fault. And without judgment, I just went, oh, Stephanie, come on. Like, this is what you do. What? You created the monsters that are in your house at nighttime now. And I realized that I had gotten us, because of it being summer, I had been keeping us out later in the evenings. I had been having so much fun having like this afternoon play time, that we'd been staying out until 4 or 5 in the evening and playing at the creek and doing bike riding with friends and going and hanging out at people's houses in the afternoon. And it had been so much fun. And I realized that that was something that I was really craving, and I was paying for it. So yesterday we had a home day, and at 3 o'clock I made dinner. We ate dinner by like 3:30. 4 o'clock we went for our evening walk. We were back by like almost 5. At 5 o'clock we got downstairs and we started our nighttime routine, and within 20 minutes they were asleep. Hallelujah. It had been taking almost an hour and a half, which I know happens with my kids. When my kids are wound up and like once they get overly tired, if they're not in bed by 5, they all of a sudden start getting this like second wind, which is why I tell people, try putting your kids to bed ridiculously early and see what happens. See what happens, because a lot of times when they get, yay, thank you, when they get a second wind, then it's torturous. So they were getting a second wind and it would take an hour and a half to get them to bed, and they were going to bed at 7:30, sometimes 8 the past 3 weeks. So hey Tracy. So that's that. So using this to observe how I was actually sabotaging my own rhythm. I was really enjoying doing things, summertime things, but my kids are not there yet. They were getting absolutely depleted. They were getting way too run down and worn out, and to the point that they were now like in reserves and not feeling well. So use your calendar as a observation tool. What part of the day, if you're writing down like, oh, there was a meltdown at 4 o'clock, write down meltdowns for yourself and for your kids. Like, write down when you're getting frustrated. I notice that around like 11 a.m., I get a little like frustrated, antsy, figuring out if I need to get out of the house or if I can stay home. I've been writing that down. What happens? Do I need to eat? Do I need to just pause? Am I trying to do too much? Write down any insights that seem that are creating the struggle. I know I'm going into a lot more detail about this, but I really want us to stick with it, because I see how powerful of a tool this truly is, of just taking a moment to observing your day. So, Tracy, I asked everybody to share their desires. Have you figured out kind of like what it is or what's your intention? Today is a great day. We're almost at a full week with the calendar. If you're only a couple days in, it's a little glitchy. Sorry. I will talk slower. If you've just joined in with us with the calendar, perfect. What is your intention with it? Is it to simply see what works and what doesn't? Is your intention to create awareness? Is your intention to create beautification of your life, to create the magic, to find the passion, to be inspired, for more peace, for more joy? What is your intention? Just one word, if you can, write it in here. For hey, Jessica B, I was just asking what your intention is while we're doing this 30-day challenge. Just write it in. Write your intention. So, how else can we stick to it? I've been kind of layering with this 30-day intention, layering new rituals with it that I want to incorporate, because I know, get our flow back. I love that, Laura. Yeah, I know you had a big catastrophe happened to block your flow. So I'm so happy to hear that you're like feeling like you can step back to help myself stay in grace. I love that, of just being gentle, right? Being gentle with yourself. I love that intention. Love, love, love it. If anybody else would like to write their intention for this 30-day challenge, I would love to hear your intention. So with this 30-day challenge, a few days before, I think I'm on day 14, so about a week before I started doing yoga, and I was just trying to do it whenever during the day, but I now have that I wake up, I literally wake up, go straight to my computer, put the yoga on, and I start doing yoga for 15 to 25 minutes, however long the thing is. If you guys want to join me in that, I'm doing yoga with Adrienne's 30 days of yoga. Yoga with Adrienne. That's a YouTube channel. I really enjoy it. It can be as easy or as challenging as you like it, but I've really been enjoying, I have so much more energy just waking up and doing yoga first thing. So if there are yoga mamas who teach yoga in this Facebook group, and you would like to hold like a 10-day yoga challenge for us, or do lead us through yoga. I know Amina does yoga. I know, I'm sure there's other women who teach yoga here too. If there are things that you would like to guide us through, sorry, a crow just flew by with a snake hanging out of its mouth. Ooh, right? What kind of spirit medicine is that? If there are things that you do, if you are a nutrition coach, or if you do other things, message me. Let's figure out how we can actually get you guys to be able to help support these women. If you're willing to give of your time to this group and create a little challenge for us, or if you have challenges that you create, we could, you know, create a thing. So I know there's lots of coaches, lots of mentors, lots of amazing, empowered women who actually help other women in this space. If you would like to create something, let's get that going so that more people can become more inspired and more just learn. So let's just open that space up too. So message me if that's something that you have going that you would be interested in doing for the group. Let's see. So stick-to-itiveness. So I started doing yoga every morning. And then last night, to get my rhythm back on track, we went on an evening walk. I love evening walks in the summer, right? I mean, yes, my evening is 4 p.m., but I love like that, the warmth that I'm surrounded in. I love that time of day. So I'm now going to layer. So yoga in the morning, I'm in 14 days of that. And this 30-day challenge, I'm 6 days into this. And now I'm going to add one more layer of a 4 o'clock a 4 o'clock evening walk. So, and then of course doing the daily, the Facebook Live. So if you guys need kind of these, like if the Facebook Live is helping you create part of your rhythm, there can be things that are scheduled and on time as part of your rhythm. And that's perfectly beautiful because it's going to kind of help ground you. Hey, Jessica. So if you have something else that you've been really desiring to, if you look at your life and you go, man, if I had the perfect life, this is what it would look like. If you could just pull one aspect of that out and start incorporating that into your day every day, what would that look like? What is it? So please write in the comments if there's something that you would like to start doing that is a part of your magical life daily rhythm, what would it be? What does that look like? Yoga was one of mine, or just exercising. A walk is another one. So doing this Facebook Live was one of mine. And now my evening routine. So what is it that you would really like to focus on for the remainder of these 3 weeks and get down really solid? Is there a meal? Is there like meal times that have been really wonky and really chaotic that you really feel like you want to get down? So pick something to incorporate and add for the next, for while we're doing this 30-day challenge, and start layering. Just one thing. I'd say at least spend at least 2 weeks on the, spend at least 2 weeks every time you want to add something to your rhythm. Take 2 weeks to make it really solid. Add something else. Spend 2 weeks doing that, add something else. And amazingly, by the end of the month, you've got two new solid things, just one, right? Yes, just one for 2 weeks. And I feel like I am so much more successful because if I try to go, I'm going to revamp my whole rhythm today, I am so let down. I'm so let down. I want to discover our basic rhythm before adding more activities to this fall. Yes, yes, yes. And a basic rhythm could really be focusing on your morning rhythm, your evening rhythm, your meal times. So really focusing on the five pillars of sleep, eating, playtime, being space, and nature immersion. So if pick one of those. If you're like, oh man, I've got sleep down. Our sleep rhythm is fantastic. Our bedtime routine is amazing. It's down, right? Your bedtime rhythm is down. Then focus on your eating rhythm. Is meal prep and meals, focus on creating your meal plan. On Friday, I'm getting it all kind of mapped out. I'm creating a brand new monthly rhythm. I've done an activity guide before that I released for the retreat. On Friday, I'm revamping it all and I'm creating a brand new monthly rhythm guide to help support us through this journey. So I will put that out on Friday. So look forward to that. Focus on your playtime. Make sure that you are playing in what you're doing. I'm going to start bedtime rhythm. Yes, yes, yes. I know that you've done it before, Lonice, your bedtime rhythm, and it went really well. So just acknowledge that that's all you're going to focus on. You're going to put all your intention into just observing and creating a bedtime rhythm for the next 2 weeks, right? And then nature time. When during your day are you going to incorporate nature? And make it so that it's something that you could do year round. I found that at 4 p.m., if I create a daily rhythm of walking at 4 p.m., it's something that we can even do in the winter. Whereas if we do a morning walk, it's so bone-chilling cold in the morning in the winter that I'm not necessarily able to keep that rhythm. So I need to focus on eating because we're spending so much time outside that meals and snacks get endured until we're starving. Yeah, and then it's like breakdown city. I struggle with this in the summertime too because I get so caught up in all the playing that I've been more aware of, okay, I I need to start this meal or like create a snack tray or as the unschoolers call it, a monkey platter. Just make a big like smorgasbord, veggies, fruit, rolled up kind of finger foods, and that way it's out and it's ready. Just working on rhythm. It's been out of whack since the fire. Yes. So pick one part of your rhythm, just one part of your rhythm, Laura. Your morning, your bedtime, so sleep, eating, play, nature, or being space. Pick one of the five pillars and really imagine what you want that pillar to look and feel and be like, and focus on that for the next 2 weeks, and then add another part. And within, what is that? So that's the five. So like within 3 months, you can have a really solid daily rhythm within 5 weeks, or 2.5 months, sorry, within like 3 months. So probably start with the mornings. It's the worst. Yes, yes, yes. Start with an area that you're the most, start with an area that you're most determined, or that you really, carry the beloved snack bag. Yes, yes, yes. Probably it's always fun to start with the worst part because you're motivated to change it drastically right now, right? So you're not wanting, you want it to change so badly that you will put all of your effort and energy into creating that space. Visualize what you truly desire. What does it look, feel like? And then start doing it. Yeah, I love that. So, is this helpful? Has this been helpful today? Focusing on the five pillars and sticking with it. So give me a thumbs up or let me know, if this has been helpful. So, please, please, please take a picture of your journal, of your calendar, post it. Yes. Okay. Awesome. Thank you for reminding us about creating play out of whatever we are doing. It helps me so much. Oh, good. Keep repeating it. I will. Cause I have to remember too, like as I'm doing the things that I'm doing. Yes. Yes. Okay. Awesome. Thank you. As I'm doing the things that I'm doing, I get to remember like, oh, I get to go play Facebook Live. How exciting. And not that I love this time. So, and just remembering that it's all play. How do you want your play to look? How do you want it to feel? How do you want it to be? Do you want to say good morning? I don't want to get wet. I'm a little chilly. Do you want to say good morning? Say good morning to all the ladies. It's a water balloon. You don't want to say good morning? Okay. All right.
I can do.
Okay.
Hi.
So that's Zion. He's saying good morning to everybody. So... I will let you all go. I hope you have a beautiful day, and I'm going to be heading to the creek this afternoon, so that's going to be my big play for the day. And Loni says, hi, Zion! So, splash, splash, splash! All right, peace and blessings to all of you lovely ladies, and I will see you in the morning. Bye!